This is a model of a motor neuron. Motor neurons are part of the nervous system tissue and are the functional cells of that system. I'm going to zoom in a second and talk about the individual parts, but one easy way to do that is to organize them into this main area where we find the nucleus of the cell. This is the soma or cell body. We can also talk about the axon and its features. And then at the end of the axon, where we go from 3D to 2D here, is the terminal end of the axon that synapses with a skeletal muscle cell. So I'll talk about those three regions in more detail. The motor neuron has a portion here called the cell body or soma. It's where the nucleus is located, as well as all of the other organelles that the cell needs. Branching out from the membrane around the cell body are dendrites, which are easier to see here in the 2D part of the model. There are these long hair or branch-like extensions. They receive incoming information, send that information to the cell body, and then that information is sent along the axon, which is this thicker, long blue extension of the cell that travels all the way from the cell body to the muscle cell, shown here in red, that this particular neuron is working with. The axon of the neuron is insulated by cells that are called Schwann cells. Schwann cells are full of insulating myelin, and they wrap many times around the axon. So you can think of them as like insulating tape that's wrapping around and around and around the axon. That helps both protect the signal traveling through the axon, and it helps speed up the transmission of that signal. The length of the axon is covered by many different Schwann cells to fully insulate it. So this is one Schwann cell, this is part of another Schwann cell, and if we follow this axon, we can see that there are quite a few Schwann cells covering the axon. The end of the axon terminates at the synaptic end knob, also called the synaptic end terminal. This is where the axon bulges and gets a little bit bigger and then branches out into these synaptic end knobs that synapse with a muscle cell. Synapsing is just making a connection where neurotransmitters in vesicles, shown here as little gray dots, are released from the synaptic end knob across the synapse. The signaling neurotransmitters are taken up by the skeletal muscle cell, and they initiate a series of chemical signals that eventually lead the muscle cell to contract. So again, what we're looking at here is a skeletal muscle cell. And remember, skeletal muscle cells are extremely long and skinny, so we're only looking at a very small portion of one cell.